إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اصطفاه ربه واجتباه، أنزل عليه النور المبين وهداه إلى صراط مستقيم. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على عبدِك ونبيِّك محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنَّ بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فاتقوا الله وتوبوا إليه فإنه يحب التوابين، واستغفروه فهو خير الغافرين، اتقوه مخلصين وتوبوا إليه نادمين، انصروه ينصركم وأطيعوه يثبكم، واغتنموا الصالحات لأنفسكم، من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها ثم إلى ربكم ترجعون. أما بعد، يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا الله، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، dear respected brothers and sisters, a young girl went to her school and her classroom to take a test, and she looked very exhausted and tired. She sat down, she took the testing paper, looked at it, and she couldn't answer a question. Read the question, she couldn't answer it. And the teacher was watching her, and she sat for half of the time, did not write a single word on it. And all of a sudden, the teacher watching her, she started writing down, writing and writing and writing, until she answered all the questions. And then she handed her paper to the teacher. The teacher looked at her and said, "How did you do that? How did you do that? You know, the first half you didn't write a word, and then after that you wrote everything. You answered all the questions." Then the girl looked at her and said, "Well, last night I did not sleep. I stayed up all night long, taking care of my sick mother. Taking care of my sick mother. Not playing games, not watching TV, movies. She was taking care of her sick mother, and I couldn't study. I couldn't study for the test. And I said, let me come today and try my best." Then when I sat down and took the paper and looked at it, I did not know any of these answers. And then later on, I made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I made dua to Him. And I said, "Oh Allah, I ask you by the most beloved deeds to you, taking care of my sick mother, help me." And the girl said, in seconds, the answer started coming to my mind, as if there's an open book in front of me, and I started writing all the answers. And I thank Allah for answering my dua. Brothers and sisters, being dutiful to your parents, being obedient to your parents, is the deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most. Now, Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, the great companions, asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is narrated in Sahih Bukhari. He said, Ya Rasulullah, ayyul amali ahabbu ila Allah. See how the companions, they were very keen and care about doing the things that's pleasing to Allah and Allah loved the most. Then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, As-salatu ala waqtiha, to pray on time, the most beloved deeds to Allah. And then he asked, Thumma ay, then what next? Then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Birru al-walidain, to be dutiful, to be righteous, to be good to one's parents. And then he said, Thumma ay, qala al-jihad fi sabilillah, is to strive in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So being dutiful to our parents, being good to them, being obedient to them, is one of the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty, Al-Aziz, Allah Al-Khaliq, the Creator, our Lord, being good to our parents is one of the most beloved deeds to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed in the Quran, and this is an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be good to our parents. And Allah said, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And your Lord has decreed to worship none but Him and to be dutiful, to be righteous to your parents. It's an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ. When He said, worship none but Him, this is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us. This is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us. And then the next thing he mentioned, the rights of our parents on us. Subhanallah. The rights of Allah first, and then came right after it, the rights of our parents. To be dutiful and to be good to them. To obey them. And it's not just that. Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu asked him, also the Sahih Bukhari, he said, Ya Rasulullah, ayyul amali afdal? Which one is the best deed? Which is the best deed to do? He said, As-salatu ala waqtiha. The best deed is to pray on time. Then he said, Thumma ay, and then what? He said, Birru al-walidain, to be dutiful to your parents, to be good to your parents. And then he said, Thumma ay, and then what? He said, Al-jihadu fi sabilillah, to strive in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's one of the best deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's the deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it that a person come closer to Him, closer to Jannah. Ibn Mas'ud, again in Sahih Muslim, asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ayyul a'mali aqrabu ila Allah, aqrabu ila al-jannah. Which are the deeds that are closest, that take someone nearer to Jannah, will take us near to Jannah? He said, As-salatu ala waqtiha, to pray on time. And then he said, then what? He said, Birru al-walidain, to be good and righteous to our parents. So the Birru al-walidain is to be what? Birru al-walidain is to be obedient to them, is to obey them, to listen to them, to answer them when they call us from the first time. They don't have to call 10 times to answer. And I'm not talking only for our beloved children here. I'm talking to us as adults, as someone who's married, to always, even, it doesn't matter what is our status is, our position is, how many children do we have. We still have to be obedient to our parents. This is the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the deed that makes us closer to Jannah, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One time Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, and who is Ibn Abbas? He's the cousin of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he's not just the cousin of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but also he is Habrul Ummah, the scholar of this Ummah. Wafaqihuha, he's the faqih of this Ummah. Wa imam al-mufassirin, he's the imam of the mufassirin, tafsir al-Quran. And the Rasul, he's the one who the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for him. Allahumma faqihu fi al-deen wa allimhu al-ta'wil. Oh Allah, teach Ibn Abbas the understanding of this deen and teach him the understanding of the Quran and the meaning of the Quran. So a man came to Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. He said, Ibn Abbas, I killed a man. What should I do to come closer to Allah, to do tawbah to Allah and come closer to Him? Then Ibn Abbas asked him, do you have a mother? Is your mother alive? He said, no, she's dead. He said, well, go make tawbah to Allah and make the best thing that you can do from ta'at, obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so He will forgive you. Then a man was standing next to Ibn Abbas and he heard him what he said. And he said, Ibn Abbas, why you ask him about his mother? What has to do with this, with his mother? Then Ibn Abbas answered, he said, wallahi, la a'lamu amalan aqrabu ila Allahi min birri al-walida. He said, I don't know, la a'lamu amalan aqrabu ila Allahi azza wa jal min birri al-walida. I don't know of any deeds that can bring you closer to Allah and more beloved to Allah than be righteous and good to your mother. And this Ibn Abbas was saying that. This is the great ibadah. It's ibadah, it's ta'a to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be good to our parents. It's great ibadah. And was not only prescribed for us, but also for the prophets and messengers who came before us. All the messengers, they were good. That was one of the greatest qualities of the prophets, being good to the parents. A prophet, a messenger, subhanAllah, we're not talking president or anyone, but a prophet and a messenger. You know, alayhi salam, he's making dua to his parents. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِيَ مُؤْمِنًا. Oh Allah, forgive my parents, forgive me and forgive my parents. Nuh alayhi salam, ulul azm, making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive his parents. And his Yahya alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa barran bi walidayhi wa lam yakun jabbaran asiyya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about Yahya, son of Zakariya alayhi salam. He said, wa barran bi walidayhi, and he was righteous and dutiful to his parents. Yahya alayhi salam, wa lam yakun jabbaran asiyya. He wasn't trying to disobedient. He wasn't disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he wasn't disobedient to his parents. And he's Isa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa awsani bis salati wa zakati ma dumtu hayya, wa barran bi walidati wa lam akun jabbaran shaqiyya. And Isa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa awsani, saying, wa awsani bis salati wa zakat. And Allah has enjoined upon me as salat, prayer, and zakat. This is the ibadah. Allah enjoined upon him the ibadah. And the next thing after the ibadah said what? Wa barran bi walidati. And to be righteous to my mother, to be good to my mother. Wa lam akun jabbaran shaqiyya. And wasn't tired, miserable. This is the prophet and the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ulul azm. And here we see the sahab, the companions in the tabi'een, like Ibn Mas'ud, who one time his mother asked him to bring a glass of water, a cup of water. When he came, she was sleeping. And he stayed all night long standing next to her, afraid that she will wake up and does not find the water. And he is Hassan al-Basri, who sits with his mother to eat. And when he sits with his mother, he doesn't eat. And they ask, oh Hassan, you know, you say you talk about the righteous, being righteous to your parents, good to your parents. Why when you sit with your mother, you don't eat? He said, well, I'm afraid that I will go pick up something that my mother has desired for it. I will take something that my mother has desired for it, so that's why I don't eat with her. And he one of the tabi'een on this cause, Hayawat ibn Shuraih, who was sitting, he used to sit in the masjid, and having halaq of ilm, of knowledge, teaching students. And his mother came to him and tell him, oh Hayawat, get up and feed the chicken. Get up and feed the chicken. Then he will answer. He doesn't say, oh my mother, like I'm sitting here with the student teaching, this is ilm, knowledge. He's not playing games. No, it's ilm, knowledge. He will get up, feed the chicken, and comes back to his halakha. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, for the parents, He gives special status for the mother. In the Quran and the Sunnah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانِ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا. And in another ayah, حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا. He mentioned the mother. And in the Sunnah of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when a man came and asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ أَيُّ النَّاسِ أَحَقُّ بِصُحْبَتِي, which one is has the more right for my companionship to be with them and to be good to them? He said, أُمُّك, your mother. Then he said, then who? He said, أُمُّك, then your mother. Then he said, then who? He said, your mother, third time. Then he said, who? Then he said, your father. SubhanAllah. The greatest status Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the mother. May Allah forgive all our mothers and have mercy on them. Make them enter the Jannah. A young girl came to her mother, handed her a list. The mother took the list, read it. Number one, helping you cleaning the house, in the shore of the house, $5. Number two, taking care of my siblings, $10. Number three, taking care of the dishes, $2. Doing well on my report cards, $3. And she added them all up and gave it to her mother to pay her. So the mother took the paper, looked at it, read it. She took the pen and wrote on the paper, carrying you for 9 months while growing in my stomach, free of charge. Taking care of you when you're little, sick, staying up all night long to take care of you, feed you, free of charge. Taking care of you when you're sick, taking care of you, feeding you, cleaning you, wiping your nose, free of charge. Loving you for the true love, free of charge. Then she handed it to her daughter. She read it, the daughter read it, and she had her tears in her eyes. And she said, you know, mother, I love you. And she wrote on the paper, paid in full. Paid in full. Is it paid in full? No, Allah is not paid in full. No matter what we do to our parents, we can't pay them off. And especially to our mothers. You know, SubhanAllah, Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, one time he was in Hajj making tawaf, and he saw a man carrying an old woman on his shoulder. So Ibn Umar, he asked him, who is this woman? He said, this is my mother. And oh, Ibn Umar, this is a man who is carrying his mother, asking Umar, did I fulfill the rights of my mother on me? Did I pay her enough for that? Taking her for Hajj and carrying her on my shoulder with tawaf. And he said, Ibn Umar responded back, he said, wallahi, this what you did, this tawaf carrying your shoulder, is not worth it one of the contraction, the pain that she went through when giving you birth. Just one contraction of labor. But what you did is good, and may Allah reward you with the little thing that you did, may Allah reward you a lot. So to remember and to know that no matter what we do in our life, would not be enough to pay off our parents. So this is as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to do. This is the characters of the prophets and messengers before us. This is the character of the Sahaba and the Tabi'een. This is the characters of those who wants to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wants to come closer and near to Him. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined upon the mankind, the insan, to be good and dutiful to his parents. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, رِضَى الرَّبِّ بِرِضَى الْوَالِدِ وَسَخَطُ اللَّهِ بِسَخَطِ الْوَالِدِ. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be pleased with us, our father should be pleased with us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be displeased with us if our father is displeased with us. Also, the father has a role taking care of his children, showing them support and help. You know, one time a man came to his son's room. He was sitting studying. He came to his son and put his hands on his shoulder, his oldest son. He said, "Son, who is the strongest one in this world?" So the father was expecting to say, "Oh, you, daddy." He said, "Me." He said, "Well, the father, what? Let me ask you the question again. Son, who is the strongest one in this world?" He said, the son said, "Me." And then the father was kind of disappointed. He was expecting that to say, "Oh, you, my father, you're the strongest one." So he left the room, and as he was leaving, he turned around, he said, "Son, who is the strongest one in this world?" He looked at him and said, "You, Dad, you are the strongest one." So he looked at him and said, "How come when I asked you first, who is the strongest one, you said me, and when I left, and then you said you?" He said, "When you had your hands on my shoulder, I was the strongest one in this world. Because of you. When you left me, then you are the strongest one in this world." That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us so many ayahs, so many ahadith about the great virtue of being good to our parents. Because we have to be careful, very careful. As adults, parents, children, we have to be very careful. Because عُقُوقُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ is to be disobedience to our parents, one of the major sins. It's not in any sins, it's a major sins, like killing, like drinking alcohol, like doing gambling. This is what's عُقُوقُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ. To raise our voice when we talk to them, this is عُقُوقُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ. Don't say أُفْ to them. So imagine someone talking to his parents, to his mother or father, and raising his voice. Or when they call him, he doesn't answer. Or when he sees his parents need help, he's sitting watching TV or playing games. That's why we have to be careful, very careful. And it's something very serious that we have to learn and we have to follow to earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to earn his Jannah. And as the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us, عُقُوقُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ, being disobedience to the parents, his punishment will be in this world, definitely, before the Akhirah. Being disobedience to the parents needs a tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I remember this, subhanAllah, very well. One of my students, he's grown up and married and has children. And I was sitting one time telling him about the importance of being good to your parents, that to help you memorize the Quran. And I know this for my students. When my student comes to me, and I know him very well, he does very well, and sometimes he starts be stuck on a page or having hard time memorizing the Quran. And I come tell him, "Come here, I want to talk to you. What did you do?" You know, ma'asiyah. If you have a ma'asiyah, you cannot memorize the Quran. Our heart is a container. It has either the Quran or the ma'asiyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cannot be both of them in the same place. And subhanAllah, most of the time, they say, "I wasn't good to my parents." And even one of my students, subhanAllah, when he graduated, we asked him to give a short talk and to encourage the students. And one of the things that he said, "When I used to be good to my parents, it was easy for me to memorize the Quran," that he was saying. "And when I used to be disobedient to them, I had a hard time memorizing the Quran." So going back to the stories, one of the students said, I was telling them about, you know, in terms of the ma'asiyah, stay away from ma'asiyah to be able to memorize the Quran and hold the Quran in your heart. He said, yeah, you're right. You know, one time I was talking to my mother and I raised my voice. And then I left, I came home to pray Isha. Then when I said, Allahu Akbar, started reciting the Quran. And he said, there is a surah that I know very well. I had hard time reading the surah. I had a hard time reading the surah. I knew the surah very well. And I couldn't finish it. Then he said, when I said salam, I went and ran to the phone, picked up the phone, called my mother and asked him for forgiveness. Yeah, we'll show right away. We'll show right away. Brother and sister, this is a very important character that we have, that we have to have. It's the ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with these negative influences that we have around us, I tell you, public school is what they teach them. I'm not saying this, someone who came and tell me, that's what they taught us in public school. That no one has right on you, not even your parents has no right on you. Not even your parents has right on you. That's what they learn. Brothers and sisters, it's very important to have this institution, Islamic institution, school, any institutions that help to teach our children, learning their deen, learning their ibadah, learning their ta'a to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the same students who told me that, he went to Al-Huda school and he graduated high school from Al-Huda school. And his graduation party, he gave a speech. And he said, now I know what it means to be obedient to my parents. Now I know what it means to listen to my parents. So it's urgent for us to learn and for our children to learn that. And to have to support these institutions. Brothers and sisters, we have an annual fundraising on December 31st for Huda School. Please try and come join us. If you cannot, make dua. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This dua could be much more better than any millions of dollars. Because you never know. Someone's dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could help us, could help this institution to continue its message, to instill this good qualities, this deen, to learn, for our children to learn this deen. And I saw this results. When one of the parents comes and says, Jazakallah, Brother Muhammad, for my children now they changed at home. They changed. That's what we have. It's not enough. I know at home we teach them these values, but this is not enough. They have to go to Islamic school, to Islamic place, masjid, school, anywhere, institution, to learn these values, to reinforce these values, to live these values. And at the end, it's for the sake of our children. If we truly love them, we want to live happy life in this dunya and happy life in the akhirah. We have to teach them these values. Oh Allah, Allah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to teach our children. Oh Allah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us and our children from the thing that we learn. Well, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us as a strong Muslims, that strong ummah, helping each other. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa barik lana fi ma a'tayt, wa qina sharra ma qadayt, fa innaka taqdi wa la yuqda alayk, innahu la yadhillu man walayt, wa la ya'izzu man adayt, tabarakta rabbana wa ta'alayt. هذا وصلى الله وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
سووا استقيموا اعتدلوا سووا صفوفكم brothers and sisters make sure you have straight line fill in the gaps الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الأرض وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر